this weekend, I'm planning on taking a bike ride out to Burney Falls. I live in Burney, California, and one of the most beautiful places in the world is Burney Falls. But I'm going to ride my bike out there, and it's, you know, between 40 and 60 minutes one way. And there's nothing out there, just a road and the waterfalls. There's no gas station, no place to pump up your tires if you get flat tires. So one thing I wanted to do is change my front tire. I bought this this new tire here. I already replaced the one on the back. This is called a Cujo Hamovic, H-A-M-O-V-A-C-K. And believe it or not, I got it through Home Depot. Home Depot is one of my favorite places to shop online because they give free shipping. So I bought two of these, Cujo Hamovic. Oh, there's the name right there. These are 26 inch tires, 1.95, and they're mountain bike tires. And each of them were only $13.45 each, and they're shipped out of the Midwest to California. And so that's about half the price of a bale tire. And these actually have more thickness and knobbies on it, more like a traditional mountain bike tire. So I highly recommend Home Depot for ordering smaller stuff because they always give free shipping. So one of the first things that you have to do when you're changing your tire, of course, is let the air out of the tire. And that's what this little screwdriver is for. I don't use this for anything else other than letting the air out of the tire. Do not use this to take the tire off of the rim. You will tear up your inner tube inside. So I prepared my kit of tools. Got my screwdriver to let the air out. Got my little pump here. This is my tire pump. Works just fine for what I need it. I also like to use, this is a 15 millimeter combination wrench. It's open in on one side, closing in on the others. And I primarily use this to take the tire off of the rim because I can dig in there with a round end and not worry about ripping a hole in my inner tube. And it's the right size to take the nuts off of the tire axle. And I have a pair of pliers in here and a small ratchet and another 15 millimeter socket in case I want to use the socket instead of the combination wrench. And most importantly, when you get a flat tire, you need to have a inner tube. And I learned from experience that you need to carry two inner tubes because one day I was riding my bike, I changed the flat tire, I went about 200 yards and I got another flat tire. So take two inner tubes minimum with you. So that's my repair kit for traveling around, biking around. Put everything back in here. This is my nice Adidas backpack that I use. And one of the most important things you need to do is get yourself a helmet. I actually picked this one up at, Salvation Army. And I think it's probably for people that climb, you know, the mountains or something, but it works just fine for me. And the reason I highly implore you to get a helmet is because a friend of mine wasn't wearing a helmet. He went over the handlebars, hit his head on a curb, and it killed him. They found him lying there later in the day. He was out in the middle of the street, and nobody even noticed he was there until some car came by and saw him lying there still. So please use a helmet. Save your life. So this is my new tire. And now I'm going to go ahead and take the old one off. Like I said, I already did the front tire. I already did the back tire. So I'm going to change the front tire now. Get my tools here. I think we'll give the ratchet and the 15 millimeter socket a chance to work here. Ah, there we go. You know what? I just made a mistake that I think that you can learn from. Do not take the tire off of the bike until you split the rim and get your tube started. So you see I'm using the closed-in part of the combination wrench. You can stick that in there real easy. You don't have to worry about ripping a hole in your tube, and just kind of move it around, get it to come loose. There it is, it's done. Great to have a combination wrench like that. Now, one of the things with these kinds of bikes, these mountain bikes, is you need to release the brake and unhitch it from the brake cable. And it's pretty easy to do. There we go. So that way the brake's fully open and you can easily take the tube and the rim and everything off of the bike. Let's get the other side here loosened up. There we go. All right. So you don't have to take the nuts completely off. Leave them on the drive shaft or the center shaft. There's my tire. Now, one of the things that I would recommend, since we're not actually changing the tube, leave your little cap on the place where you put the air, so that the tube doesn't come out of the hole when you start pulling this tire off the rim. I think that's a little better than having the thing come out. That way it stays lined up and everything. But you know, each his own. You can do what's best for you. All right, so the tube's out, the old tire's gone, and here's the new tire. Alrighty, so got my tube on there. I'm gonna put the tube around inside the tire itself, just like this. Get it started all around. Feels like there's quite a bit of air still left in this tire, so I may or may not have to let out some more air. Pull the nozzle down. All right, so what we want to do is get the tire started on the rim, which I'm doing right now. And let's see here. I started one side, now I'm working on the other side. Not that difficult. As long as it airs out of the tire, it's pretty easy to get it back on there. This is a 26-inch rim, 26-inch tire, mountain bike tire. All right, so the tire's on there. Make sure you pull that little nozzle thing out. Keep it straight as you can. All right, so you're going to notice that there's kind of an arrow pointing of the pattern. Well, you want the arrow to point towards the front of the bike. And since the bike's upside down, it'll actually be opposite. So drop it back in here. There it goes. And then they have these little lock. Oh, what would you call those? There's almost like a lock nut that goes in, has a little pin that goes in there. Get it to go down in all the way. Oh, it's hanging up on one of those pins. There it goes. All right. So that one's in the pinhole. This one over here in the pinhole. There we go. There we go. No, this one. This one's not in the pinhole, so let me lift it up here. Gotta make sure it's in there so that if for some reason the nut came off, at least that pin thing would hold it on for a little while. All right, there we go. All right, so you can hear it rubbing there. It's actually rubbing on the cable for the brake. So I think I got it pretty close, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the brake cable back on. There we go. So the brake cable's on. That's the front brake. Now, you can see it's not rubbing on any of the brake shoes. And we just tighten up a little bit on this side, a little bit on this side. Make sure it's kind of even and centered so that it doesn't hit one of the brake shoes. Give it a test here. Yep, we're good. Now I'm going to crank it up here all the way. Yeah, that one's tight. And now this one. Good. Cool. So that's all ready to go. And now my little pump. I guess if you have a regular tire pump that, you know, you push up and down, it might be quicker to do it. This is more of an emergency pump for when you're on the road. But this is the one that I use. I think everything's all done. Make sure that the tire stays on that rim. Sometimes when you put the air in the tire, it'll maybe bulge out one part of the tire off of the rim, and you got to keep an eye on that and make sure it doesn't pop off the rim as you're pumping in the air. All right, so let's get this going here. All right, looks good. This bicycle, I actually bought it from a friend of mine for $65 as a Kent. And I've had it for, I don't know, over 3 years. Put a lot of miles on it. I've replaced the tire several times. And the centered bearing where the drive shaft is, I replaced that after like the first year, because the ones that came with the bike pretty much wore out real quick. And they were the old type of bearings where you have to grease and everything. So I replaced that center shaft bearing with a really nice Shimano sealed bearing pack. And I haven't had any problem with it. I'd highly recommend, if you're having bearing problems, go for the sealed bearings that Shimano puts out. They are excellent. All right, let's see here. Now that's not completely filled yet, but I'm gonna take it over to the gas station that's just down the road, because there's enough air in it right now to ride on the bike, and I'm getting tired of pumping. All right, so that's what you do. Everything looks good, not rubbing the brake shoes. I think we're about ready to go to Burney Falls tomorrow. Here's my bike, brand new tire. One thing I did buy, I didn't buy it, but you see on this bike, I got one of those old timer seats. It's much more comfortable than those racing seats that they come with. And, you know, to be honest with you, I found that on the side of the road, and it's been a blessing. You don't have something like this, your butt's gonna hurt after a long bike ride. I also added these extensions to my front handlebars, because if I'm down like this, I'm leaning over a lot. And this gives me a break to kind of sit up straight for a while, even though my hands aren't on the brakes. If it's safe to just kind of cruise a little bit, I'll switch over to these. and go back and forth between those and the regular handlebars. So I highly recommend get some kind of extension so that you don't have to be leaning over the whole time. All right. Tomorrow we go to Bernie Falls.